He ain't doing Scarlet Woman.
And there's a lunatic again, so,
he likes,
you know,
madness, so I'm saying Mez, Serenovus, no Dashi. And then I'm just calling out a script. He's deleting characters right now. He's like, what?
No, keep going, Joe. Keep going. I've got everything open here. Let's just see what you got.
He's definitely doing roles... Pixie.
I end up thinking I'm a Lunatic Legion again. Great.
The only roles I haven't seen are Snitch, Poppy Grower, and General. So if any one of them are on, then I'm sold.
Yeah.
I think he definitely hates
any one of those three.
I agree with you. It's a Pixie Poppy Grower.
Oh, gosh.
Oh.
Pixie.
Yeah.
Except how do you... How do you stay mad is a thing that would literally never out ever to
Ryan, I'm going
to
request some roles. I want Pixie. Ooh. I want Snake Charmer.
You know what
I want
a Snake Charmer Legion game.
Oh, no, that sounds awful.
Lunatic sucks, but it works for the script. So
Snake Charmer,
throw that in there for sure.
Poppy Grower, best game.
That is the only way. That is the only way that Snake Charmer... No, because the Poppy Grower can die. Like, Snake Charmer Legion, it just ends the game. Because you know all of the Legion. I guess you don't know one.
That's why you have the Poppy Grower in there as well. So the
they can die. Yeah, but they can die.
All right. Everyone, time to go to sleep.
I want a Washerwoman. I want Clockmaker. Let's go. Pixie.
Oh my God, this is my first game as the Godfather. That's weird.
My favorite Clock Tower roles are the ones that get vague bullshit information and completely fuck it up. So please give me General.
I've already proven I'm really bad at staying alive.
Flashy is obsessed with the Savant, for example.
Yeah, exactly. The Savant's great. It's so easy to mess up what the storyteller's trying to tell me.
Oh, I didn't even see Savant was on the script.
It's not.
Oh, you guys confused the shit out of me. I'm looking for it. Like, what? I have a whole list of Savant info because I storytell a lot. And man, it is so good to have that ready to go.
Well, I'm just going to hard claim Fisherman this whole game. And me too.
I was like, oh, I have Fisherman's Friend. I should be.
It's a demon bluff. I would bet there's a Barber and a Lunatic in play. Lunatic's fun for the storyteller because he's a Poppy Grower.
That'd be fun. Do a Poppy Grower, but give the Lunatic the real evil team.
Oh, we should ask if he does Lunatic where he uses the Lunatic token. I guess it's his prerogative on how he does it.
So, if I throw a Lunatic token in the game, if you see a Lunatic token when I first hand out rolls, you're actually the demon.
Okay. And that's if you're not doing multiple demon types to trick the Lunatic.
Correct.
Or whatever. Okay.
And then I would actually come to you and let you know
Yeah.
that you are which demon and who the Lunatic is, yes.
Okay.
Still riding on the high of winning that atheist game, so I don't even care if I get my imp lost this time.
I'm glad you believe.
Hey, I wanted to give you more room to be able to put the sign up.
Pardon?
Huh? I wanted to give you more room to put the sign up.
Oh, yay. I was just saying re-rack, please. I promise not to execute you. I hate this role. Everyone thinks this role is amazing, and it does nothing. It just, like, tells you all about the past when we've all figured it out, and we can't figure out where the demon is, and it's useless. That's all.
Okay. I'd love to give him the ability to re-rack, but I kind of like the setup here. We'll see what he does with it. Might be a quick game.
I was like, you know what would be funny? If his philo power didn't work anymore of being an atheist. So I said, can we change into a puzzle master?
You couldn't pit-hack me into something more interesting?
No. I was going to make people Serenovus and shit, but stuff was already too weird. So I was just like, whatever.
You should have made me Serenovus.
The easiest thing I could do is make Matthew the sailor, prove that he wasn't a poison player, and that would save me for most of the game.
Well, wouldn't you have won twice if you made a demon?
I thought about it. Ryan was never going to let me do it, I don't think. He was just never going to let me go there. Nah, even if I made myself. Nah, I couldn't do it. He wouldn't change my atheist token into anything.
Yeah, because then he'd have to follow the rules after.
He changes me into the only evil player. I'm like, oh, fuck.
Good luck. no minions. Well, I still would.
Well, then my win condition goes away, and you, Matthew, get fucked at the end.
He just changes you into the good demon.
But we would have followed you anyway.
Yeah, that was my first time playing an atheist game. I had no idea what the hell was going on.
That was my first time playing an atheist game, just FYI.
I didn't know what was going on, so I just followed Joe when he said I would win with him.
Hello, Daniel.
Hello.
I am here to tell you there is a drunk and a barber in the game.
Drunk and barber. Okay, so the minions of Vigor Mortis. Okay, thank you. Wait, you're welcome. Is there a poppy grower?
That's all I have for you.
Okay, it's poppy. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Big issue, right? If you're gonna have Legion Lunatic. I guess you could just do.
What was
I
that?
Guess you could just be a dickhead and be a Legion with a
Legion.
That would actually make the game so rough. That would make
with
the game
a
rough
snake
as
charmer
shit.
And a poppy grower as well.
Yeah, because then Legion is actually the Lunatic would be a good vote for Legion. Holy shit, that just makes the game really difficult for good.
Which is why there's a poppy grower and a snake charmer.
I like the fact that there's a poppy grower potential.
Alright, so I didn't get the rest of my demon info, or I didn't get the minions, so there's definitely a poppy grower.
God.
You're probably the Lunatic, then.
Oh my God, I was about to ask, was Thomas evil last game? And I'm like, no, he still wasn't evil.
No one
he still
was,
evil. Was not evil, yes.
I have yet to be evil.
Ryan could have been
evil.
Except
that one Legion game where I demolished and won.
Yeah.
Well, like I said, you can't start a character as evil, but you can absolutely pithag them into something evil as the storyteller in Atheist Games. When I say pithag, you can just change them.
I think you can make travelers evil.
Yeah, you could also make travelers evil. I'm just saying, the only restriction on evil is starting.
Okay.
Yeah, you can absolutely one night just say, you're the poisoner now. Not that it would matter.
No, I'm the poisoner.
Chat, we gotta wait for someone to come back here.
So,
what's this script
guys...
called? Sorry.
What?
No. How often you guys? How often you guys? Are you guys streaming?
So we're streaming every Friday through this month. Next week, instead of doing Friday, we're doing the extra live stream for 25 hours. After that, I do want to actually continue weekly streams, but we might move it to like a Saturday or something if that's when we can get some more players.
Yeah.
But so it's going to be open to more, but I'd love to do some more weekly streams.
And I run random games on Sunday, Monday, whenever I'm in California, really, is because then I have nobody to hang out with and it's late at night.
You're like, sup, anybody want to play?
And I usually get a good sized group somehow. I don't know how I do it.
Yeah.
Ryan plans these out and he's like, man, I barely get fucking six dudes. At least we got a bunch of randos. And I just
Fridays
randomly will get like 12 people. That's the thing, right? Ryan, it picks up Friday and most of the people are out partying.
Hello.
What's going on, Ryan?
Hey, wanted to make sure you were back.
Yeah, I used the restroom real quick.
No worries. So, General Cal.
Yes.
You familiar? Are you comfortable with this role? Do you know what the role is?
I'm not familiar, but I did read it as soon as I noticed that it was next to me. And it says that you'll tell me whether you think evil or good is winning.
Yep.
So that's one of those things where I get to kind of just do with the information what I will.
Yep. I'm going to say, currently, slightly in good's favor.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, sounds good.
Thank you.
Yep.
Love it again.
Gordita.
Eraser?
Juggler.
Aw, Eraser.
Ryan's president.
Morning, Ravenswood Bluff. There is a spirit of ivory fabled in play, which means no more than one extra evil player can be made in this game. So, alright. There are 9 of you alive. I have died once again, but apparently I've taken Shiva,
Hazel,
and T with me. This time. The town is a lot smaller. There is a demon among you. Standard game should be 5 townsfolk, 2 outsiders, 1 minion, 1 demon. 9 players, good luck.
Mm. Alright.
Ryan always gotta keep
dying. I'm scared to talk to anyone.
Let's go, Joe. Don't be scared.
I'm scared. I guess we did good the last game.
You know what? Sure, I will say your Mazzeffeli's word, Thomas Boom Dandy. But anyways, great. What are you, really?
I'm an outsider.
Oh, cool. I'm also an outsider.
Hello. You're muted.
If I write notes to chat about my guess for the Mez word, and I get it right, is that considered saying the Mez word?
I'm going to say no, because you haven't made the storyteller. You haven't directed it to the storyteller.
Well,
I will let you see all the notes. Huh?
You would see all the notes.
I will, but unless you actually, I think you have to say it.
Okay.
Hold on.
It does say
the first good player to say the word. You can write as much as you want. It does not affect it.
Okay, cool.
Yep.
I am the dreamer.
Oh, did you dream me?
No, I didn't.
Well, then why the fuck are you talking to me? You should dream that and then talk to that person and get and bait out their info.
Yeah,
if I tell you what I am, then you won't be able to dream me, right? Because then I know that you're lying.
Because you were about to go into a chat with Matthew, and I dreamed Matthew.
Oh. Oh, I can be the third party in this situation if you tell me what you dreamed. Yeah. And then you
That's
don't tell
dreaming.
Him that you were the dreamer, and then he tells me, and I can confirm between the two of you, and we have a three-way confirm.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Because I got... What did I put? I got either the Viga Mortis... Mm-hmm. Or the general.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. And that was Matthew?
Yep.
Oh, look. Hey, T's back. T's just hanging out. Hi, T.
Hi.
Okay. okay, so here's what I will give you two informations, okay?
All right.
I'm either, and I'm a little worried. I guess the script's not that scary. Okay, I will give you snitch or seamstress, and if I'm the seamstress, I haven't used it yet. I'm safe in it. But I'm going to check you and Matthew, potentially, based on info.
Yep. And then snitch. When you said snitch, I was thinking Harry Potter. Anyways.
Snitch! You can't catch me! What?
Fine. Okay. I'm like, Joe, you might be evil. I'm not telling you shit. Anyways. All right. I'll go back to town now and fish me some more, folks.
T, do you have the Grim, by the way?
I do not. I do, actually.
Okay. Do you have all...
What are the bluffs?
The bluffs are snitch, washerwoman, seamstress.
Snitch, washerwoman, and seamstress. But I do have the Grimm, so I know who is who.
Okay. Do you have the reminder tokens, or no?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Richard, the snake charmer, is actually the drunk.
Okay.
And Tweeter the Pixie is mad about a sage.
It's mad about a sage, okay.
Yep, that's all the reminders out there.
Cool, thanks.
You're welcome.
Oh, that was my first Atheist game. I didn't know what the hell was going on.
I love Atheist games. You know, and mine, by the way, kudos. You ran one hell of a good one. That was a lot
of fun. Thank you. That was my first Atheist game, too.
Good job. Good job. I didn't know it was Atheist Final 3.
Yeah. So,
what you want to do here? You want to do a 2 or 3?
I'll give you 3.
Okay, I'll go first. I will give you the Innkeeper, the Sage, or the Snake Charmer.
Okay, Innkeeper, Sage, or Snake Charmer. Okay. If you were the Innkeeper, who did you,
Chat, we got a prediction starter for you. You got 5 minutes. If you wish to take part, who's going to win, good or evil?
Hello.
Hello.
Thomas.
It's
like, hello.
Later.
You can't see me, but I'm shaking my head at you, Thomas. Anyways, Richard, would you like to...
And the empath, the general, or the sage?
I'm hearing a lot of multiple roles. Right now.
Likewise.
I don't know why people are lying, but that's okay. Cool.
Yep. Alright.
Hey, Cal.
Yeah.
Quick, quick thing for you. Chat. Scott is in chat. He says he's rooting for you.
Oh, thank you. I'm trying, Scott. Thanks. Appreciate it. Look, before a game to get evil.
Through the clock, Lightyear, what was your number?
2.
And if you were the impact, what is your number?
0.
All right. Thank you so much.
Yep.
All right. Have a good one.
Yep. Later.
So. Yeah, and we can kill a snitch during the day. Everything's fine.
Everything's fine. Minions.
Yeah,
because
the snitch doesn't.
Oh
do
yeah,
anything.
They don't. Yeah, because is there a vortex? No, there isn't. Okay, all right. So then I will tell you that I am the dreamer.
All right. And where is that tag? Who'd you choose? Or
I chose. Joe was gonna talk to Matthew. I talked to Joe first because I did it on Matthew.
So what you thinking?
I'm fine with whatever number.
All right. Well, I'll give you General, Clockmaker, or Sage.
General, Clock, Sage. Cool. I will give you Oracle, Innkeeper, or Sage.
Hi, Jamie. There's not a snitch in the game. It's one of the bluffs, actually. So that is to help potentially hide the drunk in the game, that the Godfather knows there's a drunk in the game. So let's see what happens. The Poppy Grower is keeping it balanced right now. Otherwise, Evil would definitely be kind of more in the lead here.
Oh, where is it?
Thomas, can we chat?
Sure.
This game's spicy. Anytime anyone gives me... Anytime anyone says a mez word, I'm so tempted to, like, almost but not quite say it.
Matthew, say pineapple.
No, thank you.
I need to talk to Natalie, because I'm wondering if she gave me the wrong person here.
Well, you'll get that chance in just a minute here.
Not if I break your rules. Daniel, let's go chat. Fuck him.
I can't. Oh, just kidding.
I would. I mean, you could, but yeah. Everybody else is breaking the rules. Just fine. Thomas, I strictly forbode talking to you.
It's okay. We're seated next to each other.
Welcome back.
Gordita.
So.
Sandwich.
I think we should have a discussion about roles that are not on this print.
You guys know that butter can fly.
Salamander.
All right, everybody.
What's your favorite nomination role, Daniel or Natalie?
Grumdiddlyumptious.
Wait, what?
Gollum.
Oh, I do like Gollum.
Like, Goblin's a pretty fun one, but like, what's that other one? I can't remember.
I said Gollum.
Is it Doom Bandy?
Yeah, that one. There we go.
The Doom Bandy, specifically?
Oh.
Not the actual role. Sorry, I love teasing mezzes. It's my favorite thing.
Joe nominates Thomas. Fuck Thomas.
Wow.
Definitely awesome idea, but nominations are not quite open yet.
They're not open, Joe.
I love that the storyteller at the
Joe's in a double claim awesome with someone idea else. I'm just going to say that before he tries to sell any souls.
Everyone's cameras frozen for me. And everyone's video is choppy.
That's just because we're not moving. Nobody's moving. Yeah.
Internet movie.
I think that's a you thing, Flashy.
Okay, I'm refreshing. Flashy, yeah.
Let's do a round robin right now.
Yeah.
Honestly, A1 round robin.
Round robin.
I'm down.
Sure.
I'm the mez. The word is poppy grower.
Poppy grower.
Poppy grower?
All right, next person.
The disconnected Flashy.
I'm Flashy, poppy grower. What? Did he just say it?
So... Alright, now that Flashy's back, yeah, nominations are open if you wish.
Joe nominates Thomas.
Joe nominates Thomas.
I refuse to have extra evils in my town. He did try to make defense. Me say a word, and I said,
I'm not an actual Mazephles. I just like taunting everyone. I'm actually a bad kill here. Because
that makes
the
me even more happy to kill you. You're not the fucking
barber. Oh my god.
Now is exactly the right time to kill the barber.
Yep.
Alright.
Alright. Fine.
Yeah. If there's a Poppy in the game,
there
then
is a
this is great.
Well.
There are 9 of you alive. 5 votes needed to put Thomas on the block.
Quick, while the hand is
so wait, barber
face,
dies and then someone turns evil.
But
no,
the
they,
demon
they
can
swap
with the evil team. Unless...
Oh.
What do you mean barber
they
dies?
They swap
someone
characters,
turns evil.
They don't swap alignment.
Yeah. How do you
oh.
see the blue
oh.
okay.
yeah. Is there even a poppy grower?
I don't know.
Thomas
I
is on the block with 5.
I'm assuming I can't start a call, right?
The out barber needs to
Thomas,
die now and not
Thomas,
when
Thomas, do you remember the... Never
mind. Not today. There's no cult on the
You've got a nice butt.
Alright. Thank you so much. You've got the nicest butt for the next minute.
I treat you nominated Joe.
Sorry, that was a...
nominate Joe.
Alright. Yeah, Tweeter guys. Nominates Joe. Your accusation.
Woods chat, town crier information.
Which... Oh, okay.
Neither of those
are on the screen. Joe, your defense.
I'm the virgin and he didn't die, so we know what you should do next.
Oh.
Sorry, I poisoned him. Pertinent info.
We have pertinent info.
I hope that you guys don't ever have new players, because we're going to have no fucking clue what's going on. I mean, new
players. Joe's voice.
No idea what's going on.
We don't let Thomas and Joe play with new players.
Yeah.
Joe, do you have any other defense?
Kill Tweeter after this, I guess. After
all right. 5 to tie, 6 to put Joe on the block.
After Thomas. Why are you so confident I'm going to die? Let's lift this. Come on, everyone.
I don't want to date one of you, man. Come on, town.
Let's get Joe killed.
That's
so close, but not quite.
Oh, God.
Half of the vote.
I tried. I actually agreed with Tweeter that I should have died from the witch check there, or whatever he said.
There's no witch on this script.
Wait, no. No, we shouldn't do this. Matt nominates... Crap.
Uh-oh, saving his demon.
There's a godfather.
Flashy nominates Daniel.
There's no goblin.
Godfather.
No, godfather.
Flashy nominates Daniel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I understand.
Flashy, your accusation.
I didn't realize Matthew's logic. This is a bad nomination.
Yep, and that this is also a bad nomination.
Yes.
I'm confused. My logic reasons. Of getting Thomas off?
I'm not saying we shouldn't get Thomas off. I'm saying
no one's getting Thomas
on.
Off here.
Thomas likes to get off.
Daniel, yeah.
No means no.
I have to say, I've heard of another outsider claim, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm also bad for similar reasons.
Yeah.
Alright, whatever. We'll leave it then.
Daniel, would you like to tell us what that claim is?
My claim is? Yeah. Sure. I'm the snitch.
That's a double claim.
From who?
That's like
from you,
claims.
Joe. Joe's double claiming with you, Daniel.
Oh, we should just kill Joe.
Are all three snitch claims just minions who know there's like
Well, here's the thing. A minion knows there's a snitch because they get snitch bluffs.
Right.
No, a minion knows there's not a snitch because they didn't get snitch bluffs.
Yeah, either way, yeah.
All right, so I missed this for a second. So, Daniel, did you get a chance for defense yet or no?
No, that was my defense. So I'm killing. I'm just missing.
Okay. 5 needed to tie. 6 to put Daniel on the block.
I don't think we're going to lift this.
What's
to
tie?
It
could be a Legion game, by the way.
I think we need to
How many to tie it?
5.
We do not want to do that.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
Yeah, but though. I don't want those two.
Daniel, are you actually the snitch?
Yes.
5.
Then wait, then why do we not want to kill you? We should absolutely kill you.
No one is on the block.
The God outsider.
Same thing. Yeah.
You're 100% the snitch, Daniel.
We should kill
yes.
both of them.
You're not lying.
I am not lying.
I think it's a
Is
liar.
There any reason Daniel can lie here?
There's a Serenovus.
Ah, okay.
Who would
that
say,
makes
oh.
sense? I had to be very, very clear that there is that possibility. Okay.
Yep.
That
Daniel, sense. Are you mad? Daniel, are you willing to claim another role and then?
Daniel, if you break madness, that would actually help me a shit ton.
Because there can't be a godfather and a Serenovus.
Daniel, are you only the snitch?
It would actually be helpful if you are the snitch to
last call for nomination.
You know, the snitch to break madness.
But you also know I would never break madness. You should know this one.
Is there a mutant on this?
This
is there a nomination on Joe?
Matthew,
yeah, I've already been
it failed.
Okay.
I'm trying to nominate anyway.
Matthew nominates Richard.
Matthew nominates Richard.
Thanks, Matt.
There is... I got a 3 from him. One of them is hard claimed elsewhere, and one of the other two would be happy to die.
Alright, Richard, your defense?
I mean, if you're in a killing mood, I'm not the worst kill. It's better than a damn outsider, that's for sure.
I'm always in a killing mood.
But I'd prefer, another day or two of life. But if town deems it so.
I was kind of ready to die.
5 to tie, 6 to put Richard on the block.
No, it wouldn't be a tie to tie already happened.
Wait, tie with who?
With the other two that were tied at 5.
Oh.
4 is not enough. No one is on the block.
That would have been funny, though, if it's a 3-way tie. Like, why are we...
We're just not killing today. Is what
can Daniel and I hold hands on the block and both get executed?
Closing
anyway?
The day in 5.
I mean, there is another draw on the script.
Yeah. Demon change. Let's go.
Yeah, we really need
it's to... It's a good idea you put that spirit of...
No one is executed and dies... Everyone goes to sleep. And please stand
by. I like how
by.
He said no one is executed and dies, as if
there's... Well, we added extra seats.
Are we adding 2 extra seats?
There's a bunch of randos. I'm not seated next to Daniel anymore. I can't give him the Mazepolis word.
Oh,
hey, just
worry,
assume whoever joins right now is going to be evil. Oh. We've added a wild Daniel to the game. Daniel is pretty wild. Feral, even.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, good. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
Welcome to the game.
Thank you.
All right. Just so you know, I do have cams on at night, so feel free to make whatever facial expressions, funds, notes, whatever you want for chat. They can see it through the night
as
well.
Okay, great, cool.
All right, so we were talking, and you said you want to be either the barista or the bone collector or the deviant.
Or the deviant. I'm down to throw my hand in and see if I can be funny.
You've got a nice butt.
Let's go ahead and do... Ooh. Well, you pick. I'm fine with all 3 of those. Which one do you want to do?
Oh, man. Let's... I'll be simple. Let's do barista.
Barista it is.
I'll be funny no matter what.
All right. You are the barista. You are good.
Excellent. Great.
Right,
thank you so
much. Yep. Yeah.
Bye.
Hello.
Sorry, I was muted. Just wanted to see if you were okay with me also popping in since I saw you up in multiple seats.
I did. Absolutely.
All right. Why is my video not working? Hold on.
Okay. Just, we are streaming.
Make sure you see.
Make sure you're comfortable with being on stream and all. We do have cameras on at night as well.
Oh, yep, that's fine.
Okay. Excellent. So, do you have a preference on Traveler?
No, dealer's choice, please.
You know what? Let's go ahead and do... let's go ahead and make you... The Judge.
Judge. All right. Sounds
you,
great.
You are evil.
Okay.
And Joe is the demon.
Thanks so much.
All right. Thank you.
Correct.
Okay.
Based on my information that I got.
Let me check.
That means shit is bad.
Yeah.
We got a judge and a barista. Barista.
I hope I get barista barbered when I get killed, and then it's just 2 barbers.
It's just going to be an evil barista that allows the demon to kill twice.
That's not how barista works, though.
I actually don't know how barista works.
Barista.
One of you is going to get a special order tonight. That's all I'm saying.
Well, if I get killed before barista, then you can double barber.
What?
Because traveler goes first, then demon, then barber. So if I'm getting killed, you'll double
Sounds
barber.
Sounds legit.
What's this double barber? What's their ability works?
It's the barista. This is something that Kirby was a few about a month ago or so.
We have two travelers in town that have come in, the barista and the judge. The barista's powers, each night until dusk, a player can either become sober and healthy and gets true info, or their ability works twice, and they learn which one happens. The judge, once per game, if another player is nominated, you may choose to force the current execution to pass or fail. So they can force it to be a success or a failure. So after each nomination, when we get to the end, when I say if it's enough or not, I will then ask John if he wishes to use his ability. And if he says yes, he will either make it yes or no. But he only gets to do it once.
So you're going to prompt him?
Yes, I will prompt him.
If he chooses yes, just to make sure, then that means you will do the execution, right? So that'll end the day?
It's just correct. Pass or fail.
Yes.
If another player is nominated, you may choose to force the current execution to pass or fail. So...
They can choose it to fail.
They can, yeah, so if there's enough on the block to make it happen, they can choose to say no, it's not enough, and it doesn't pass. Or if there's not enough, they can choose to say yes, it does pass. And then
and
the
if they say yes, it does pass, it doesn't just put them on
happens.
A block, it ends the day with them being executed.
Correct.
Okay.
Can I ask the importance of this Spirit of Ivory for this script?
Barbara yes. Mazet, please.
There is a world that the barber, when they die, the demon could actually swap the Mazephles to another player, and the Mazephles power starts again.
Okay, thank you.
Like, for example, the demon and the Mazephles. That's probably how that would work.
I honestly think it's smart to just put Spirit of Ivory in almost every fucking game, in case you miss something. Because there's no reason to have five evils, or one extra evil than there should be. Mm-hmm. It really sucks.
Plain Legion.
It literally kills the tempo of the game.
Yeah, but an extra evil. Like, Legion is its own, like, beast.
Yeah, Legion is a whole thing because you can't...
Hello, Richard.
Hello, Ryan.
The barista has selected you, and you will be getting sober and healthy information today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You... can't, because the nature of the atheist precludes evil characters.
Meh, you can do whatever you want.
So to be specific, honest,
you can have it where everyone, where people can see evil tokens if they're the lunatic,
right?
And then people can be made to believe they're evil if marionette's on the script,
right?
You can also airdrop evil in after the fact. You just can't start with evil.
You scared me for a second mentioning atheist. I'm like, is atheist on this? Because that is
we just did that game.
Let's not do that again.
Was it an atheist game?
Yeah.
Did it feel bad?
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah.
Also, whoever the first person to say atheist was, they might be the medieval now. Oh, I suspect God. That was the Mez word.
That was a traveler that said it. Ooh.
I think a lot of. Oh, yeah, that does.
Oh, that could be fun. I could become evil right now? Great. Let's do it.
Okay, so Atreides definitely started evil. Now we know that.
Totally. First person I'm going to chat with is going to be the demon. Just watch. So, Flashy, can we chat tomorrow?
The no response makes it more suspicious.
Flashy, say something.
I don't
it's a joke.
Think there is
it's
a thing
joke.
I could say in the world to make it less suspicious.
There might not be, that's true.
You could say no.
That would make it more suspicious.
I think yes would make it more.
I like saying no as well whenever Joe wants to speak to me privately. Then he says no when I want to speak to him privately.
That specifically is not suspicious.
Did you get turned?
I did.
All right. Potato chip was not the word, though.
Good morning, Ravenswood Bluff. Cal did not make it through the night.
Ooh. Oh no.
That feeling when evil barber.
Natalie, this is a very quick chat. Okay.
I have a double espresso con panna for a Rick Hard. Rick Hard?
I see. Okay.
I try to use your Not the Deviant.
Oh my god, that took me way too long to figure out.
Hello, chat. Hazel, I see you're in chat. Yeah, this is not a... Oh, hey, T. Okay, just talking to our chat for a second. This is not a blind game. This is actually a game that's called Poppy Grows the Evil. It would be really funny if it was a blind game with a poppy grower in there, too. Richard chose Natalie last night for the Snake Charmer ability. Because the barista selected Richard, Richard's getting became sober and healthy. This is a weird one because he's technically the drunk and not the snake charmer. This is me trying to let him know that he's possibly the drunk. I'm giving him that information there.
But I kind of want to know whether or not there's a godfather in the script, so.
Okay.
If at some point you deem to be thinking similar to me and you decide that maybe getting rid of an outsider could be a good thing, I won't necessarily hold it against you, but I might still think you're evil.
Okay.
I don't know if that helps.
And what are you?
I will let you know that I am the general, the seamstress, or the sage.
General, seamstress, sage. Great. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm just going to chat with the storyteller really quick.
Okay, go ahead.
The shit I have to do to try to get someone executed in this town, goddammit. Sorry, should I be swearing? Is that the problem?
No, you're fine.
Okay, thank you.
Nope, sorry, just doing too many things at once.
Yeah, do too many things at once.
Yep. Hazel, you're right, I messed that up. Barista doesn't actually make a selection, it's just automatically done. Oh well, we're just going to run it this way. I'll just let Atreides know that he won't make selections in the future, that I messed that one up, that it shouldn't be that. But yeah, that was on me on that one. I don't think it's going to affect too much here.
Yes. All right. I'll see you in Town Square.
Ryan, I've been not... Hopefully I'm not the fucking lunatic, but...
You're
Daniel
not the lunatic. I'm the godfather. I know better.
That's what he says. That's what he fucking says. We'll see about that. I don't fucking buy anything that's going on here. T, you can tell me. Am I the lunatic? Ryan won't say nothing.
Do you think that a godfather would try and play off the lunatic?
Yeah, why not? Daniel's a clever fella. I put
enough
games.
I'm just enjoying my popcorn.
Why do I end up in these fucking roles every time we play, Ryan? I'm always in like some special role that is like, oh, it's Joe. Joe's a fucking atheist. Joe's a demon. Oh, it's the special. We're gonna do a fucking cool amnesiac special, and you're gonna be that guy. Okay. I guess I'll just enjoy this. Cal did die, so I guess that's the only proof. I was about to out myself as a lunatic, by the way. This right. Close. This fucking close. I was gonna say. I almost picked myself last night, just FYI. It would have been a fast game. Just want to tell you that. I was really that close
game.
To picking myself.
Interesting if that had gone through.
Well, I will give you two. The sure. Same two I gave to everyone else. It is Snitch and Barber. It's Snitch.
Oh, it's Snitch, yeah. Interesting. I still have another Snitch on my crew. That's bizarre. Okay, cool. I'm...
No, I talked to the other Snitch.
I see. Okay. I'll tell you I'm the Oracle, who got a zero, obviously, because...
No one died. Oh,
no,
except
we didn't execute. Yeah.
Well, so. You wouldn't. What that means is Tau is not in like in
didn't star pass. Yeah.
Or a bigger killed minion. The other one.
True.
So first night, I was told that good is winning slightly. I hard claimed that to two people. I hard claimed that to Matthew, and I hard claimed it to Joe. Me and Joe was supposed to exchange, but Joe did not exchange anything with me. He just kept telling me I was a liar and left out, which I thought was strange behavior.
What I find strange is, why would a demon kill a general? Well,
because I talked to Joe, Flashy, Matthew, Richard, and Tweeter. Flashy and Richard all claim general, and they both claim Sage and general. Soft claim. We did a threefer.
Can you give me those names again?
Yeah, Flashy and Richard both told me general and Sage. They soft claim general and Sage with one other role, and then Tweeter also gave me Sage with one other role.
That's interesting. I mean, based on that, what demon do you think is in this?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't think this is a Legion game. Maybe an imp.
That's weird.
Yeah. Okay. That's fine. Well.
All right.
Well, that's the Midwest version of, well, this conversation's over.
Hello. So,
just a question, because I was unaware that the barista actually selects the target.
Yeah, I made that mistake.
Okay.
They're not supposed to.
Great.
Perfect. Yep, chat fixed that for me also. They're like, wait, barista
all
doesn't get to select.
Good.
So,
all good.
My
good
bad.
Good job, chat. Good job, chat. Keep us storytellers in check.
Exactly.
All right,
yep.
Bye.
All right, bye-bye.
So, Daniel, you feeling Poppy Gore again?
Oh, I'm sorry?
You feeling Poppy Gore again?
I've never been in a Poppy Gore game before, so I don't know what the feeling feels like.
Got it.
Ryan, can I ask a storyteller console, please?
Sure.
I only want to say yes because I think Ryan's been asking for a Poppy.
Hello.
Hey, so I've got a question for you, rules-wise. If a player's ability has a storyteller choice.
Okay.
Would you would you allow yourself the option to defer that storyteller choice to that player? Or would you never involve that player in that storyteller choice?
Give me an example if you could.
Sure. So Atreides has claimed to me that you went to Atreides in the night to ask him to choose a player. But the barista role does not have the barista player make the choice. It's a storyteller choice.
There may have been a slight error on my part on that one.
Okay, so normally speaking, you would not defer.
I would not.
You never defer a storyteller choice to a player when there is normally a storyteller choice.
During the day, I might talk to them and ask who they think would benefit from it. And if I agree, I might take it into advisement, but at the end of the day, I will make the decision myself.
Right. You will never, blatantly defer the choice to them.
Correct.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Yep.
Two traveler. Yeah, so we're at 8. So we're going to need to skip a day anyway, so it doesn't really matter. We lose out on one night of info, I guess. But
I really hard trusted you.
Need you guys right back in town, please.
Yep. Okay.
I guess we just shoot elsewhere. Fine.
All right.
I mean, whatever.
We'll let you guys chat for a minute, but nominations are open.
It's my turn. I'm ready to die.
No. No. Make the fucking demon waster kill on you.
No. Kill me. Make someone else evil.
Richard,
I definitely
want to
kill.
Because if
Richard
me
nominates
you...
oh, sorry, himself.
There's quite a few roles that I've had, soft claims on that are kind of more valuable than I am at the moment. Go ahead and get rid of me, because I could be a hindrance, but I don't want to be that hindrance. So, and my defense, please, no, don't kill me.
All right, 10 of you alive. 5 votes needed to put Richard on the block.
I don't like killing people who want to die.
I mean,
I'll put him on the
no assisted suicides here.
Stuck at six.
No euthanasia.
Six is enough. John, do you wish to use your power?
I do not.
All right. Richard is on the block.
So we have 10 alive. And that got seven.
Six.
Okay, that's still beatable. Matthew nominates Natalie.
Matthew nominates Natalie.
Drunk or evil? I'm not sure which.
All right, Natalie, your defense.
Okay, so there's a few claims in town of a certain role. I am actually it. Now this kind of ruins what I was going to do. I am your sage. So you might as well. Yeah. But there's a few people that have claimed sage that are pretty suspicious now.
Really? I haven't heard anything from sages.
I have. Believer.
Oh, actually, six to tie, seven to put Natalie on the block.
Natalie's good. Always trust Natalie. I would say that Natalie lie in my first conversation with her.
Yeah, I did.
I actually have never seen an evil Natalie so far. It's always been good.
Lying is... That's the name of this game. That doesn't mean
Atreides, the problem
is not enough.
She lied to my face.
Not claiming a role, it's giving info that's false, that sound wrong.
I will say, there's not going to be a lot of double... There's not going to be a lot of double claims because of...
Right, if you just say, oh, I'm this thing, and then you're not that thing, that's one thing. But if you give false info based on what role you're claiming, that's harder.
Sure.
I would say noting the script, if I am in play, there's probably also a poppy grower in play, just to balance shit out.
Anybody else show Legion, or is that just me?
Anyone else what?
Legion? You're getting a Legion vibe?
I feel like it's a Legion game.
Really?
That's paranoia.
If it's a Legion game,
Legion on script, I always feel the opposite of what
I mean. Paranoia is the name of it's like Legion's middle name, right?
That's all Legion is paranoia. You know, I haven't even thought Legion this whole time, but maybe I'm just gullible.
If it's Legion, second call for nominations. Legion, and then today's kill will also be a Legion if Richard is good.
Oh, I did actually forget, John, did you wish to actually execute Natalie? I forgot to give you the option on that one.
Oh.
I do not.
Okay.
Oh, I was like, might as well.
I apologize.
May as well just do it.
Flash nominates Joe.
Flash nominates Joe.
I want to shoot in. I want to execute into one of these two snitch claims. I'm not that afraid of the Godfather. Confirming the Godfather to be in the game would be useful information.
Joe, your defense.
Yeah, the Godfather would be pretty excited to kill me. So I will just be Uno reversing.
All right, six to tie, seven to
also,
put Joe.
Also, Flashy is in a triple claim.
Wait, what?
One of my soft three for threes is in a triple claim.
Yeah,
sorry, you're in a triple
it's
claim
actually
as far as I've been
told. Both of them.
I don't think we're lifting this.
No.
Oh, you can lift it if
three
you want.
Three is not enough. John, do you wish to use your power?
I do not.
All right.
That would have been a ballsy play if you just immediately.
I'm perfectly happy with Richard dying here, but I think Flash, he needs to go tomorrow.
Yeah.
Last call for nominations.
Everyone, look at Richard's perfect lined up eyes. Gotta love it.
That's beautiful. Oh my god.
I do appreciate that.
Not oh my god. At all.
That's spooky as shit.
It's Halloween.
Perfect for this weekend.
You're welcome, chat.
Richard, did you out your role to everybody yet?
Closing the day in five.
All right, yeah, keep that shit secret.
Richard,
I think it might be a poppy grower game based on my conversations.
Richard, did I guess your role right?
Yeah.
Richard is executed and dies. Everyone go to sleep.
Yeah, Richard gave me two. I'm kind of guessing which one of the two.
Let's keep that on the DL because if it is a poppy grower game, that's solvable for evil to help themselves.
That's fair.
Yo.
Hello, Flashy. The barista is giving you sober and healthy information.
Good to know. Thank you, friend.
You're welcome.
I was like, wait a minute.
It's the atheist pit hag.
Oh my god.
God.
Please, let's not talk about that again.
It's the atheist alchemist
but we won.
Pit hag.
Mm.
Yeah, I was perfectly lined up for like 3 minutes, and my eyeballs were watering because no one was noticing what was going on until Atreides pointed it out.
When they say atheist Pithag, they did not mean the atheist alchemist Pithag. They meant an atheist who was allowed to make game decisions and had alternate win conditions.
Oh, I see.
Game.
Okay.
Yeah, which we got just it. Played.
Has anybody been affected by the barista yet? Like, they were in play yesterday, I forgot.
It was Richard, wasn't it?
They weren't in play overnight.
Oh, they just joined?
No, I had...
So they're going to go into effect tonight, or...
Richard, did you have the double, or the sober and true?
Sober and healthy.
Nice.
Yeah. Which is why I was comfortable putting myself on the block at that time.
Fair.
So...
Can you give Natalie a...
Hi, Daniel. I just want to confirm you are targeting Cal,
yes.
Who is already dead.
Yes, I'm seeking the kill. Yes.
Got it. Just wanted to confirm.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. All right, so the barista is giving flashy, healthy information. He's going to find out that Richard is the drunk. Joe has decided to kill Tweeter, our pixie sage. Unfortunately, Natalie is still alive, so Tweeter's not going to get any information off of it. Daniel, because we executed an outsider, Daniel gets a kill, but he's going to sink it into Cal so that no one knows there's a godfather and player that Richard is the drunk. Let's get back to it.
Mesephiles. And now Undertaker.
Also atheist and pit hag.
It would add up that there's a godfather if we're in play and there's a drunk. Otherwise, there's no other... You just assume
Natalie
a drunk's in play most games, I think.
Natalie was just going off roles that are physically possible.
Yeah.
The storyteller loves having a drunk in play. It just makes setup so much easier. You can
Ryan, the storyteller. Do you love a drunk in play?
So if a godfather's in play, which would be a sexy choice, but it can't be because it's Serenovas. Yeah, there's a Serenovas in play, guys.
Yeah.
Oh, so like we should have killed it at the Stitch Fair?
I mean, you can kill whoever you want, but you seem pretty evil with your shit going on.
We'll find out if Daniel...
Based on what?
...is a snitch. Or Joe.
Good morning, Ravenswood Bluff. Tweeter did not make it through the night.
Tweeter, can we talk?
Suspicious Tweeter who claimed something.
Natalie,
can right, you something to chat with you, please?
You still mad?
Hello, T.
Sorry, the damn button. What happened in the middle of the night?
All right, so we had a few things that happened here. So the barista, I had the barista select Flashy to get sober and healthy information since he was going to get Richard as the drunk. So he actually did get Richard as the drunk. Because the drunk died, Daniel got to kill, but he sank a kill into Cal instead to hide the godfather. And then
okay.
Tweeter, because he died as the pixie, but the sage is still alive, did not get to use the power of the sage.
Okay, cool.
Yep.
Thanks. Sense. There's something suspicious about a snitch wanting to live.
Yes.
Like
exactly.
A barber should. Snitch, you've set the game. Like, yeah.
Yep.
I agree.
Cool. Bluffs, you know the snitch isn't in place, so it's a safe thing to bluff, right?
Right.
And it's the only safe thing to bluff because you don't get bluffs.
Right.
So, and you don't have assuming there's a snitch, there's a poppy grower, you don't get a demon to go ask for bluffs. So, two, like one of them bluffing it makes sense. Two of them doing it where there's only one minion doesn't make sense because the demon would still get bluffs.
Right.
So, I mean, maybe the snitch was a demon bluff, and so
possibly.
So maybe it might be Daniel and Joe, and Ryan gave the demon the snitch as a demon bluff so that when there was a double claim, they could figure out who the evil team was without killing the poppy grower. That could be going on.
For sure. Like I said, Joe was real weird when I talked to him earlier today.
Yeah.
I hard claimed the general. He told me I was a liar. He wouldn't hard claim his, and then he left out right in mid. You know, I'm like, hey, what about when he left out? So, like I said, Joe didn't hard claim anything.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's a very likely world. All right, thank you, Ben.
Yep.
Oh, man, they've got Joe's number already. The problem is you've got John, the evil judge, who can save Joe for one day. He's going to out himself as evil, and that's going to be an exile vote right there immediately. But that might give Joe enough time to survive if they can get through another day or two.
Then I will out everything that I know. So, but I just wanted to give you that bit.
Yeah, because I haven't heard of Undertaker yet, but we'll see.
Neither have I. And I don't know necessarily if they are if it's in the game, but I'll give it some time to see what happens.
Oracle Zero.
I'm the Undertaker. I got sober and true information last night that excellent. Richard was the drunk.
Richard was the drunk snake charmer. Okay, that's fun. Okay.
So, like, that then creates the world where both of them are evil.
Where both of... Oh, Daniel and Joe, you mean?
Because the Undertaker count is Thomas as the barber, Richard as the...
Yeah, drunk. That's fascinating. Okay, thank you.
Cool.
That I believe him, but I'm also the snitch.
Hmm.
All right, I'll see you in Town Square.
So there's two snitches?
Yes, I think Joe is Sarah Novus locked since the first day.
If you want to back up into something else and try to save that snitch, I mean...
I'll just say we roll swapped and I'm the innkeeper, I guess.
Yeah.
Because you said innkeeper, right?
Yeah, I'm going out to my keeper stage. Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
Hey. Good play there. Natalie already came out as a sage. Your pixie's dead. He can go ahead and try and claim that. Hopefully that works. Hopefully Natalie can get targeted tonight and she's going to get some good info. She does. Do you all want some more friends over here in Town Square?
You said
it's been a little late, but I'm not opposed to it.
Mm-hmm. Huh? No, not travelers. Do you want the rest of the town to come back?
Oh, no, give them all the time they want to
chat. Oh, yeah, give them more time. I'm chilling.
Actually, Cal, I wouldn't mind chatting with you real quick.
Yeah, what's up? Let's go.
Ryan, can I ask you a quick question?
Absolutely.
Hello, Ryan. Let's say I was actually under Sarah Nova's lock to be the snitch. Can I still use my seamstress ability on Night 1? I just can't give out the information. Is that how that works?
Correct.
Okay, cool.
So, if you're Sarah Nova's locked, you can still use your power at night when it's just us. You just can't give out that information or claim that you use that power.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yep.
For what it's worth, the sage also learned Daniel and Flashy. So I very, very much like the Daniel and Joe evil world based on that.
Okay. So we should kill Daniel first.
I agree.
All right.
There is a Scarlet Woman too. So Joe could just be Scarlet Woman and we have to kill both of them.
I guess you're right. Yeah.
So okay. That's my world until we learn otherwise.
Yep. All right. I'll follow you.
Cool.
She might be now. I've got a plan.
I can't, Joe.
Natalie, you're in a double claim. I figured it out, though. I think you're fine. I think I figured it out.
Natalie's fine.
Yeah, I think I figured
I'm fine, guys.
I have a single dry cappuccino for Matt the W.
Amazing.
Did you double barista? Did you choose yourself and double barista?
Yes, exactly, yes.
For the record, I didn't learn either last night.
No, yeah. It wasn't you. I've spoken with the person who I affected.
I see, okay.
Yeah. I'm just being silly.
There's a storyteller have an announcement for us?
Yes, the game is over.
So,
grim reveal.
Wait,
is that the game? Natalie, hold on. The Natalie double claim is resolved because we think Pixie. Natalie, don't answer that
question. I'm not going to say, but I have a good idea of what I'm thinking. I don't want to give you info.
I'm just going to say, if that is the case, that original role is dead and they are safe to claim the thing. But if it's not, then don't listen. Fair enough.
There, I, I've been sold on a world here in which killing both of the snitch claims is actually good.
Yep. So
nominations are now open.
Right, Thomas nominates Daniel.
There you go.
Thomas nominates Daniel.
I'm going to pass it to Matthew.
Okay, so here's my world. If there is not a snitch and there is a poppy grower in the game, I don't know that for a fact, but just go with me on this world. The only thing safe to claim as a minion is the snitch, because you know you didn't get bluffs, you know a snitch is in play. Ryan could then give the demon snitch as a bluff, as a way for evil to find each other without needing to figure out who the poppy grower is, if there is one.
Interesting, interesting.
So there's also mechanical information behind this. I'm not going to out it, but I think the person who got that information should out it. And I'm going to wait a few seconds to see if they do.
I will out it. I am your undertaker. I received true and sober information last night that Richard was the drunk.
Fun fact, that's not the info I was planning on being out, but that's...
Yeah. Damn it, Matthew!
I don't think the other info should come out, because it also... Yeah, so, with that, sorry, I was going to leave Flashy's info out, because I didn't think it was necessary, but there you go. That also puts into doubt that there are that many outsiders, but again, there's other information out there that I think should also come out that also points at Daniel being demon. I am again going to wait for a few seconds and let that person decide if they want to do that or not.
I guess Sage. I got Sage paying on Daniel and Flashy.
Yep, that's the rest. So Sage ping on Daniel. There's a Sage ping on Daniel and Flashy by Tweeter. Richard was seen as the drunk, which means there are way too many outsiders. And my meta theory about Stitch.
That's all right, Daniel, your defense.
I do not mind dying here. Especially since it will clear world views, I am good, but to clear the world views, yes, you should kill me.
Alright, there are eight of you alive. Four votes need to put Daniel on the block.
I'd love it when they don't put up a fight.
I was thinking more of, you know, the dead player coming out with their info, but whatever.
Joe voted for this because he's the Scarlet Woman and he wants to become the demon. So
make me the demon.
Five is enough. John, do you wish to use your ability?
I do not.
All right, Daniel is on the block. Any other nominations?
So I move to exile John.
Flashy exiles John, or wishes to exile John.
In the world where John is evil, he can save Daniel by literally any other nomination happening at any point, so we should prevent this from happening.
I do agree. Sorry, John.
John, your defense?
It's the life of a traveler, but you will be judged. I could talk later about the questions I have about the circle.
Alright, there are 11 of you. You will not be using your death vote in order to vote for this if you wish. It is a free vote for you. You do need a full majority of 11 players, so 6 votes needed to exile John.
Cal, are you trying to speak? Because you're muted for me.
That is a good question. He's been chatting for a minute.
Yeah, same here, Cal.
Cal, you still can't hear you.
Cal.
On the phone? Is he on the phone?
He might be.
Yeah, okay.
On the phone.
He does right, work.
7 is enough. John is exiled.
Okay, so we are now at 7. So tomorrow's final 3. Do we get rid of the other one?
It makes sense.
Like, yeah. Then you get Matthew, a double kill. Potentially Matthew a double demon.
Matthew moves to exile Atreides.
Yeah.
All right. Another exile vote.
Oh my god.
I don't need to add anything. It's almost
it's,
final.
It's honestly the smart move. I have been good this entire game, but you don't go into final 3 with a traveler. Like,
all right.
Yeah.
Are we in final 3?
That's a lot.
We're about to be.
Yeah.
We're getting close. So 6 votes needed to exile Atreides.
Well, we don't need mine.
Doesn't matter. I'll throw my hand into the bag. Also, I have a large oolong tea for J on R.
J on R.
Just getting all the names wrong.
Oh, 8 is enough.
I can't touch anymore. I can't do it.
Atreides is exiled.
I'm loving
there it. There are now six players
why are we,
alive.
Why are we exiling Trini's
got
the funny
exiled,
medium?
But they haven't been fired, so they can still barista from the dead.
In my vote, Daniel's a demon. This should just end the game.
Last call for nominations.
Knowing Starbucks labor practices, I'm not surprised by this.
Probably Scarlet.
The problem is there's no such thing as the deviant barista. That's what I need.
So. That would be pretty funny.
Closing the day in five.
Just go to any small cafe on Church Street.
Tracks.
Daniel is executed and dies. The game continues.
Scarlet Woman.
Oh, Ryan loves to do that. He loves
theory.
To do his little cheeky.
I got my theories on this one.
His little fake out.
So this should clear up a couple worlds then, right?
I make a suggestion to town. We should not talk between now and when we get to Final Three.
Yeah. That's fair.
About the game.
Correct. Yeah.
About the game.
There are five of us, though.
We can talk about how delicious these caffeinated beverages are.
Sorry, I know that makes for a boring stream, but...
Let's talk about Gorditas.
Gorditas?
Yeah. That was a good
what
one.
What does everyone think about Constantinople?
I can't wait to Mezephiles trigger everyone this late in the game.
Can you imagine? Someone's been, like, pushing on the world and then suddenly has to, like, completely 180.
No thanks.
Hello. choose two players if you wish.
Nope.
No swaps?
There's no other evil players. I'm dead. So my play here is that I want our Undertaker to see the Godfather so they know there's been plus one outsider. That covers
okay.
me.
Alright.
Alright, bye.
Can I travel back? Can I travel back in? It's the deviant.
Can we... Are you like Googling like barista puns right now?
No.
No.
That was really creative though. I'll give you a little bit of applause.
Yeah.
Not a line.
That was good.
Hello. So I saw your sign.
Oh.
What do you expect me to tell you today?
I expect you to not tell me anything. I expect to wake up and you tell me I died in the night.
Ah.
But if that doesn't happen, I expect you to tell me that Daniel was the Nodashi.
Fortunately, can't do that for you. Daniel was the Godfather.
Yeah, that makes sense.
All right. Thank you.
Aww. Go quietly into the night. Oh. We're in Final Four now.
Good morning, Ravenswood Bluff. Thomas did not make it through the night.
We had a barber swap.
Don't like that.
Oh, that's
the
terrifying.
Barber swap will happen tonight.
All right. Sorry, I keep forgetting to connect with you on this. Okay. So what has happened? All right. Joe selected Thomas to die. Then chose not to do a barber swap. Flashy saw Daniel as the Godfather.
Okay.
So, true information, no barber swap has happened. We're down to four. It's Joe, Flashy, Matthew, and Natalie. But I think Good's got it. They know that Joe is evil.
Yeah, I have that feeling too.
Yep.
Okay, cool, thanks.
I think he just opted out. That's the only thing I can think of.
Yeah, because it's...
Hey, Flashy, one shot. Swap
characters. Absolutely.
Don't know. I know I'm accounted.
I feel like yeah. I don't know now. I don't know if Joe and Matthew are evil, if you're not evil, or if it was... What's his name?
Are you?
Fanny something? I am yet to be discovered. At this point, I'm good. I'm just confused.
Yeah, I mean,
official.
Yes.
Role.
What are you? You're not the empath or the dreamer?
No, I'm not.
Are you the sage?
I could be.
I are.
Okay. I don't really trust you, so I'm not really gonna say.
Well, there's
anything,
apparently there's a sage ping on me, so you can't be the sage unless you're the pixie sage.
Who knows what I am?
I mean, I don't disagree with killing myself for town.
Yeah, because I think you're evil minions.
I'm not evil, but like, if I survive, which was not possible, they were just going to kill me in Final Four anyways, or three, Final Three.
Because the only other person that I think might be, no, would be, oh my god, Flashy. Flashy or Joe and Matthew, if you're not evil.
Well, I mean, you're just naming every single live player that
I know.
Well, are you sus at the moment?
At this point, it's Matthew or Natalie, and I'm not sure which. Because the Godfather has to be minus one or plus one. And so if it was minus one, that means Thomas was lying this whole time for some reason, which makes no sense. Or if it's plus one, then Joe has to be telling the truth. In which case, Tweeter, why did Tweeter lie or get false information?
I trust Tweeter socially.
What on the script drunks Tweeter when I see you as the drunk?
The only thing would be Nodashi, but I mean,
Nodashi has to go through Thomas and Daniel, which implies Joe.
Yeah.
But then why? Where's the outsider that we're missing? Where's the lunatic?
That, I don't know. Whoa. Where'd he go?
I don't know. he jumped into another chat, it looks like.
He sure did. Wow. No bye, no nothing. Just zoop.
Yep.
All right, cool.
Oh, Flashy is so close. He's not considering the Vigor Mortis world. The Vigor Mortis, killing a minion would create the poisoning, so that could explain Tweeter. Although Richard and Daniel both dying during the day doesn't help with that. But the Vigor Mortis minuses one outsider. That's what he's missing. So let's see. Joe, it's not ending yet. Joe's got at least someone on his side believing that it might actually be he might be good.
Oh, and really? So there would be times, Ryan, actually maybe you can answer this.
Yeah, please.
For the purpose of Spirit of Ivory, are Travelers players?
No.
Okay.
Oh, so we're less than players. That hurts.
I mean, we sort of are. Like,
In this case, because the Spirit of Ivory would be in play, if I made a Traveler evil, that would be to balance the game out and not the extra evil in game.
Yeah. Right.
Oh, gosh, well then you're evil.
Okay. All right. Sure. Okay. Sure thing.
But I did appreciate your puns, even though they were scalding.
Well, you know, I try.
All right. I'll see.
Hello.
Hello. Loving the two travelers just going. Which one of us is evil?
I am living for this world right here. Literally, Flashy talks to Matthew, and they're totally dead set that it's Natalie. And then all of a sudden, Flashy goes, "But wait, what if the Nodashi jumped to Joe, and it's Joe, and he's the Nodashi? And what if there's a lunatic?" And I'm like, "Yo, you're so close. You're so close."
Flashy's conversation with Richard, he started going, "No, it's not Joe. It's either Matthew or Natalie." And they're trying to figure out the outsider count, and he's not even considering the Vigor Mortis. He's like, well, there's obviously a third outsider, which would be Joe as the snitch. And he's starting to believe that, and then
I don't think for these whole last few nights or days that anybody's considered that there's a Vigor Mortis in play.
Exactly.
I think everybody wants to believe that at first it was a Vortox, and then... or not a Vortox. At first it was just regular Imp, and then now it's an Odashi. And then there was like one night or one day when everybody thought it was Legion. But like Vigor Mortis right over their head.
Well, the thing is, there's no way for the demon to change types in this script.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was like, so... bro, guys, you're so it's right there. It's in front of you, bro.
Oh, it's right there. The other thing is I was expecting John to use his power to save Daniel. Because he was going to get exiled either way. So yeah. If he uses his power, Daniel's safe. Yes, they could still have attacked Joe, and that would have actually ended the game. But it would have made John sus. It would have really shown that Daniel's the demon. And if they'd done that, then today try and execute Daniel, then it absolutely would have... They would have won, because there's no way they would have...
Oh, yeah.
If they didn't kill Daniel or Joe yesterday, then Joe could survive today.
If only John didn't fail as a judge.
Yeah, it's all right. He's still trying to play good, though. He knew he was going to come out as evil, and I think he's going to try and use his death vote here to sway it.
Okay. That's what I'm thinking. But Flashy and Matthew are kind of on to Joe, so I'm just going to see how this plays out. Listen to more conversations and figure out if anybody is smart enough to catch on to what's really going on.
All right, well, here's the question. Do we bring them all back to Town Square now? There's yes. four live. They could choose not to execute today, let the demon take one more kill, drop it to three.
Yes, I live for the chaos.
All right, let's do this. Let's head back to Town Square.
But...
It's... Damn.
Where did there are two evils, but I don't
I think the... It's not a Mesephiles.
I don't think it's... I don't think it is, but I think it sounds...
Okay, Daniel, backwards. Or Matthew?
Yes?
Your story doesn't make sense because Tweeter would have been okay. poisoned at the time he saw... me and Daniel as the demon, but it does work if Daniel started as Scarlet Woman. Joe's poison would go all the way to Tweeter.
What are we talking about?
Would not go or would go?
No, Joe. Joe's poison.
Just go to bed.
Joe's started no starting no dodge.
Oh, but when we executed him, yeah. Okay. All right. So I've told everyone that I want to sleep. I forgot the Mez was a thing. So do we have three evils alive?
Including yeah, Serenovus, guys. We don't have a Mez.
I thought the only Serenovus was Daniel.
There's the Godfather.
Yeah, if Serenovus is Daniel, still. That's not something you can
I know that one person's information points at Godfather, but I don't want to put all of our eggs in that basket. I still want to talk about it.
If there's a Godfather, a then there's three different outsiders.
Are there enough for a Godfather?
That would be me, Thomas, and a drunk. Yes, that would be fucking three outsiders. That's what I'm trying to tell you, as I think Flashy's blowing smoke up your ass. I've been trying to put... I don't know how else to say this, is that Flashy's been either the Mez-turned person that's been trying to kill me all game, so his Godfather, who's obviously either a Godfather or a Mez, right? So he can get his kill. In Flashy's world, Flashy could sell anything as the Undertaker. Could tell you there's a drunk in play. That would cover up the fact that there's a Godfather versus a Mez. And it would make me look like somebody who's not even in play, right? So these are all things that Flashy can sell you. No,
but if there's both...
Daniel has to be evil, so I'm kind of okay sleeping here.
Yeah. All right, but... I will say for everyone, there are four alive. If you do choose to execute today and you do not get the demon, there's a chance that most likely the demon is going to... Evil will win. If you do choose to sleep, you'll probably be on your last day tomorrow. So with that, nominations are open.
I'll sleep.
What if there is...
If I'm evil, Matthew, who's my minion?
You wouldn't know if there's a poppy grower in game, right?
I don't think there is a poppy grower.
No one's there, I'm asking
Matthew to logic it out.
I have a question, though.
Who would my minion be the way the game has been played?
Actually, what's Cal?
There's supposedly a clockmaker...
If Cal was the poppy grower,
Flashy called the clockmaker the drunk, so that would benefit Flashy in that situation.
Richard
so
was clockmaker? I don't think Richard was clockmaker.
Oh, that's what I heard.
Second call for nominations.
What if there was a Godfather and a Vigor?
That would be
plus then, one minus one.
We, well, we didn't get there two,
could
we
be
didn't
just
get
zero outsiders
kills,
at that point.
We didn't get two kills with the Barber
guy. Zero outsiders.
No, it could go either way with Godfather.
We didn't get two. Well, no, the. Then, if Daniel's the outsider, we would have got two kills, exactly.
Yeah.
All right, let's sleep. If the Mez is going to win this game, then GG. But I don't think
last call for nominations.
That would be a shitty way to go.
Yeah, they would have earned it.
From my world, there's no Mez.
Closing the day in 5. There are no executions. Everyone goes to sleep.
Can I get Serenovus? Humble request.
You think there's still two living? That would be a barber play.
You could Serenovus me. Well, if there's a Vig, the Serenovus can do whatever they want. Even if they're dead.
No, only if the Vigor Mortis
if they
killed.
Got killed.
If the Vigor Mortis was killed by...
Which is possible if Tweeter happens to be the Serenovus that got killed.
That's a fair point. That is possible. I didn't think about it that way. That well.
So if you just Serenovus me in...
Hello.
Hello.
So Joe has selected Matthew to die, which means now we're about to tell Daniel and Joe that they're the evil team. Not that they didn't already know.
Oh yeah, they most definitely know. They're both planning on using Snitch together.
Exactly.
They're so gonna go out holding hands anyways.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. So we're gonna wake up with Joe, Natalie, and Flashy as our final
three. But hey, the barista traveler, how do we say his name? Ed Caritas? He hit the nail on the head.
He absolutely did. I saw that. I was trying not to like make any facial expressions with it. Oh, that was great. He did.
Big
he
brain.
Did awesome with that.
Big brain.
Absolutely. All
right. Wake up, Joe and Daniel.
If there were a harlot, I would make them evil. Actually, so
I'm mad as the harlot. How would you even play that?
You wouldn't. Everyone would know you were Serenovus. Can you get Serenovus into the lunatic?
Good morning, Ravenswood Bluff. There are only three of you remaining as Matthew died in the night.
That sucks.
Yep, that makes sense.
Ryan, can I get a story to our consult, please?
Absolutely.
Evil already knows this. I was the poppy grower.
Hello.
Quick question.
Mm-hmm.
So I was shown the snake charmer token. The Undertaker saw me as the drunk.
Mm-hmm.
But the barista chose me on night two. Since I'm the drunk, if I'm the drunk and the barista gives me sober and healthy information, do I then get true information as a snake charmer?
So that was one that I was trying to figure out. In this case, yes. I'm not sure it's really how our other storytellers would do it, because technically you wouldn't be the snake charmer if you're actually the drunk.
That's what popped into my head last night. Yeah. So, all right.
Yeah, I could probably do either way with it, kind of depending on if it's beneficial or not. I think most storytellers would probably say that you are getting sober drunk information so that you would still get the information of what you think you are, but I might make it actual sober information for you as even though it's drunk, I might still give you the proper information.
Okay. All right. So that helps. Thanks. Appreciate it. All right.
Godfather token. So I have to, I'm kind of wishing you, like, I'm glad you died, Matthew, because it clears up the world for me. It has to be Joe.
You saw the Godfather on who?
On Daniel.
Daniel, I assume, right? Yeah.
You saw Daniel as the Godfather?
Yep.
Okay, well, you've just basically confirmed my role.
No, because then there is no demon.
Why?
Wait, there's no demon.
My last one outside.
Wait, that's the world I have built. Why does that not make sense to you, Flashy?
What the fuck?
Because then, because Tweeter's pointing at Daniel and me as the demon, and Daniel, we killed Daniel and he didn't die. And so
you guys are gonna want to hear this from
that means Tweeter is poisoned. Wait, the only way Tweeter can be poisoned is if Joe is Nodashi, going through Thomas the Outsider, John the Traveler, and Daniel the Minion to Tweeter and to me. But that means I'm poisoned. And so I got the drunk as true information because of you, Atreides.
Right. I get that.
But
this
that
is like Occam's
Daniel,
razor on what's the most logical thing here. Ryan, can we do a round robin?
Can Flashy
I've heard a round robin, so let's do a round robin. We're going to start at the very top with Thomas.
Barber.
Joe.
Oh, I'm obviously the no dashi. I'm the snitch. Flashy. Apparently I poisoned Flashy, who's gotten perfect information
Undertaker.
In the entire game.
Poppy Grower.
Barista.
Sage.
General.
Richard?
Oh, sorry. Snake Charmer. Night one, I chose Daniel. Got a thank you. Night two, when I was chosen by Atreides to get sober and healthy information, I chose Natalie. She is not the demon.
Yeah.
All right, Tweeter.
I am your pixie sage that saw Natalie as the sage.
Daniel.
Well, sausage. It's Natalie.
Oh.
I have a rules thing.
Yeah, because okay. Twitter was
hold
never
hold on.
It.
Let's finish the round robin, then I'll do the rules thing.
I'm the snitch. Still.
Sure thing.
John.
No, I'm the judge. Obviously, don't believe not judge.
I'm sorry.
We want to make sure you're all included. That's all. Joe, you had a rules question.
Richard, if you are the drunk. The barista doesn't save you from that. Your character is the drunk. You are not the snake charmer.
That's right.
You have not actually cleared anybody. You're welcome.
But I have.
Okay. Tweeter
did though.
Wait.
Yeah.
I pulled Ryan aside and asked him that specific question, and he said that I would get information that's true for me. So.
So he ruled
it's,
it.
It's true for you, as
the drunk.
But if you are the drunk, that's the information.
Nothing's true.
Because that is your actual character. It has nothing to do with poisoning.
No. That, I understand that. That's why I went. Yeah. That's why I went and asked him. If the
that's fair.
If I'm the drunk and the barista chose me and I was told I was going to get sober and healthy information, would I get information for the character that I think I am,
or
the drunk?
Yeah. That's a good question.
I'd get the information.
Yeah, it's whatever this. If the storyteller told you that's how you ran it, then that makes sense. Like, it's
so,
up to him at the end of the day.
Richard, you're still Snake Charmer?
That's the token that I was given.
Drunk Snake Charmer, yeah.
But, so, can we ask Ryan this publicly and more specifically? Ryan, if a drunk Snake Charmer was chosen to get true and healthy information and then Snake Charmed the demon, would they change?
In that case, because they are the drunk and not the snake charmer, no, they would not be able to change.
So Natalie is not cleared by Richard.
Okay. To give you an idea, I can give proper info to a drunk. Let's say it was a different situation. Let's say there was a fortune teller in play or something. It was a drunk fortune teller. I could decide to give them true, proper fortune teller information as to try and benefit, depending on how I feel the best balance of the game is.
Right.
Correct.
It's a little difficult with a snake charmer because it's a little different than an information.
Who's the sage?
Me.
Natalie.
Tweeter can't be anything. His power wouldn't work.
Oh, Tweeter.
Exactly.
Yeah,
which is why Tweeter's information earlier
doesn't claim to
see
me.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
But Tweeter shouldn't even have an ability.
Right.
You don't have an ability.
Yeah.
I mean,
it was all a bluff.
So just pretend the info never existed.
Trying to get Natalie killed.
Okay.
Oh, you lied. Gotcha. Okay, that makes
sense. Yes, you lied.
Here's my world, guys. Joe's no dashy, poisoning me, and Fleshy, then Barber Swap.
If he poisoned you, you wouldn't see Natalie.
I know.
None of this makes sense.
Tweeter didn't see anything.
Never mind.
Because it's not a no dash.
There's no world where I'm the no dash. But Atreides made a good world where it could exist earlier, right? Atreides mentioned that potential.
I mentioned a vigor mortis.
That's what I'm saying. I was going to get at that. So there's a potential world where there's a vigor mortis and a godfather in play, which makes contradictory things.
Who still can be used.
The no dashi thing doesn't make any sense.
Okay.
All right, we are down to our final three.
That makes Tweeter the minion, I think. I don't know how bad
Joe, Flashy, and Natalie, the floor is yours as the last three living. Nominations are open.
I was really sus of Flashy, but I have no clue because they've seemed to get all of the Undertaker info, so unless they've been just really good at talking to people. Although the whole Godfather thing's been confusing.
I mean, to be clear, Flashy got information that you could make up.
Yeah.
Which, Yeah.
Drunk and a minion, you don't...
That's fair, yes. Those two would actually make sense. Whatever. I'm the outsider. Natalie... If you want to kill me, whatever.
I am not sure between the two of you, to be honest. But
Natalie, it's totally
If Natalie was a demon, how does Tweeter see a sage?
He's the minion.
Tweeter has to be poisoned somehow.
He's
how
the
is
minion.
He poisoned night one?
If Natalie is the no dash,
if Natalie is the demon, how am I poisoned? Because Daniel,
hold on, Flashy. Actually, we have this. If Natalie is the no dashy, Cal would be the minion. Richard's the drunk. Now we get it.
I see
that's
Daniel as
the
godfather,
and I'm
not
the minion. I'm the general.
I'm just gonna nominate Joe. Let's just do one.
Natalie nominates Joe. Your accusation.
I'm trying to find a world that makes sense.
Does anyone have a better explanation for the world of Joe? Because I'm thinking out of
the world of Joe.
Flashy, the world of Joe. I'm just like, he was the person that day one, I told I was a dreamer, whatever. He didn't kill me. Went to Matthew with that information, I think. Told him the next day I was the actual sage and I've been alive the whole time. I never talked to Flashy, so I don't really know.
All right, Joe, your defense.
I'm the snitch. Been the snitch all game. It would be a weird thing for my minion to double claim a snitch role. That doesn't make any sense, right? It just, it doesn't, there's no world where me being the demon and then my minion also being a snitch or whatever. It doesn't make any sense. So
Matthew,
go ahead and kill me.
Matthew,
I think Flashy's the demon in this situation. Why, this is the only thing that makes sense out of all this.
All right, two votes needed to put Joe on the
block. I don't know if we need to put all the dead votes on it.
Put it all up.
All of them on it, Natalie. Every single
There's a reason Flashy's
four at most.
World.
This is my only world.
Well, I can't know the world where Natalie's evil and I'm being a godfather. But...
Four is enough. Joe's on the block. Flashy or Joe, do you wish to nominate?
I wouldn't know who to pick.
If I see a godfather from Daniel and Natalie's demon, Tweeter cannot see a sage. He cannot see it. There is no world where he does. So
that is correct.
It has to be Joe.
Or it could be you, but I don't know. I have no idea.
I literally don't know.
Joe, you're not going to nominate?
I don't know which one to nominate.
Is this an atheist game? No.
I think
pick one and roll dice.
I think Flashy's the only nomination here, Joe.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Joe nominates Flashy. I haven't had any information all game, so it's, and people have been icing me out apparently since Flashy called me early as some kind of evil team. So I have not had any info going forward. All I've had is my social conversations with like three people. So anyway, Flashy, the world that you built could have been made up. You're calling that Daniel is the godfather. That would be a good cover for whoever your actual minion is that you learned last night. So I have no idea. Maybe you're actually the Undertaker. Maybe you've been Mestern. I don't fucking know. All I know is I'm staring at a snitch token. There are three outsiders in that world where you're the godfather, so. I don't know.
Flashy, your defense.
If I'm evil, who's my minion? There's no minion in this world if I'm
me.
Evil.
Me. I died at night.
You tell me you learned last night. That's all I got.
Use your own adventure.
So, I think if we don't vote this, it doesn't really matter.
A vigor in a popular world could absolutely accidentally kill that minion. 100%.
That would make sense.
Four votes to tie, five to put Flashy on the block.
Daniel, put your hand up on this, and one of you evil travelers, let's tie it.
Thomas. Chaos.
Oh, Daniel!
Oh!
Oh, wow. Yep, there it was.
Not
there
debating.
It was.
Oh my god, I was pranking y'all. Get
three
pranked.
Is not enough. Flashy, do you wish to nominate Natalie?
I do not.
All right, then Joe is executed.
That was real suspicious.
And dies. The game is over. Congratulations to the good team. You found your demon.
I caught it.
Why did you torture me with this vigor mortis play? I told
Why
you.
Why did I go first?
No, Joe was the vigor mortis. I figured that out.
Vigor mortis in a fucking poppy girl game is the worst thing ever. Oh, but by the way, vigor mortis with one minion is the worst fucking thing ever. There's nothing I can do in this game.
That's also true.
I have less outsiders in play. All I have is me, hoping that
I had to convince Joe he was not the lunatic. That was fun.
Oh yeah. There's no reason to give me the fucking vigor mortis.
Yes. First night I went to Joe asking him to select someone. He says, screw this, I'm the lunatic. I said, okay, still please select someone. He was actually the vigor mortis. causing your game to go down to only to one outsider. But Daniel, your godfather, brought it back up to two. Your two, of course, were Thomas the Barber, and as Flashy, your Undertaker, found out, Richard thought he was the Snake Charmer, but was actually the Drunk. So that was actually a really good play there. Tweeter, was your Pixie, who did act correctly see Natalie as your Sage. Cal was your General, who only got one night of information since he was selected to die. He got Good is slightly winning, and the only reason for that is because of your poppy grower, Matthew, in the game, who kept, who was prevented them from knowing each other, but because of the snitch bluff, they were able to find each other out. Because there was already a barber and a drunk in the game, my only options were to give either lunatic or snitch as the, as a bluff to so that they don't see drunk immediately, or the town doesn't immediately assume drunk.
I was going to claim snitch.
And I did not want to give lunatic because Joe already would have known then at that point he was not the lunatic if he saw that.
When?
Your travelers, Atreides was your good barista, John was your evil judge.
Naughty. The fact both of y'all jumped in on the troll throwing last night.
Yeah, that was funny.
Flashy was going to nominate Natalie.
I don't choose this life. I don't want to be a fucking Vigor Mortis in a two evil game. That's not fun.
I did Vigor Mortis with the poppy grower so that if you accidentally killed Daniel, Daniel would still keep going.
That's fine. Daniel and me went in a conversation. He's like, are you the evil? And I'm like, fuck you. I'm going to kill you tonight.
Well, I asked you to give me the demon because I knew the demon was the Vigor Mortis, because there's no way I would only get two outsiders as the godfather unless you were specifically the Vigor Mortis.